Hello and welcome to ISTV English News. Let's take a look at the headlines first. State Cabinet resolves to punish those who sell or keep PDS items illegally. And AMUCO reaffirms to stand for territorial integrity of Manipur. Now the news in details. The state cabinet resolved to punish those who sell or keep PDS items illegally. This resolution was made yesterday by a cabinet meeting held at Chief Minister's Secretariat yesterday, headed by the Chief Minister. The meeting was held urgently due to complaints made by various civil society organizations and political parties for not giving PDS items like sugar, rice and kerosene to the public. According to this resolution, those persons who are found with PDS items illegally may be sent to jail for 7 months and fined a penalty amount. On the other hand, the cabinet also resolved to appoint 200 numbers of SO grade 1 and grade 2 in the departments of IFCD, PHED and electricity. The said post will be appointed after conduction of an examination by MPSC. Moreover, the cabinet meeting also discussed regularization of the other ad hoc employees working under the Manipur government. AMUCO reaffirmed to stand for territorial integrity of Manipur. In connection with the present issue of border fencing, AMUCO held a one-day discussion on border fencing at Kwakaithel Mission compound yesterday. The discussion was attended by President AMUCO Dr. Mani Kuman, General Secretary N.C. Madhuchandra, Advisor K.T. Rahman, Chiefs of Border Area at Moray, leaders of Kuki INPI and representatives of various NGOs. Speaking at the discussion, many speakers said that it is high time to stand together for the territorial integrity of Manipur. Social scientist Dhanavir Laishram said that in any issue, either border fencing or territorial integrity, we should stand together and an inch of land of Manipur would not be given away to others.
Manipur ki gakai, Manipur ilam, na unna bukhona bada. Ozi na iba, rama ki fencing ki gakai, la iba isi ozi na, amu kona, any group na, Manipur ilam bada. Ipoi, full heartedly, saad sama,
The chiefs of one of the villages affected by border fencing said that in the past, Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru had given away Kabo Valley to Myanmar. Moreover, Indian government trying to give away more land to Myanmar is very unfortunate. He further added that if the border fencing has to be established, the correct demarcation should be done.
Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru ki matamda mang ki balam singdo so ekoi Manipur ki lamni adubo mujik noho na bontri ki matang sida amka adute ki hen na amka ekoi Manipur sida changsil laga moi na border sak ni hai se saba hauri se masi yam nungai te sage I've thought the Hanaki Magi original lam to the original place to the Nung Yung Ba Mapam to the Savishnu.
AMUCO President Mani Kuman said that border fencing should be done according to the norms of International Border Fencing Guideline. If the government stands against the will of the people, that would be an invitation to raise an agitation in the state. He further added that AMUCO stands for unity and territorial integrity of Manipur till their last breath. Moreover, he appealed to the people to support AMUCO.
Entire people of the entire section of the people seek active involvement in Myanmar. Aku ingin mereka akan bah pressure atau authority beri bah boundary ini authority beri bah mai kita akan pressure biar mereka bukan bah orang mana step apa ni ada. Jadi, aku lihat aku ingin isu ini dah aku ingin tuan community yang mana individual ini cepi ada ni nak lepak ke apa national isu ini nak national level dan national level dan pokoknya dah pergi.
Amju staged a protest dharna against threat to journalists and hawkers at Keshampat yesterday. The protest dharna was attended by President Amju W. Shamjai, editors of various daily newspapers, members and hawkers. In the protest, various placards with protest slogans were used. Speaking to ISTV News, President Amju W. Shamjai appealed to those miscreants not to threat again in the near future and to allow them to work freely without fear.
Hello, brokers in the power of the when a company of the company and the key of the money. The money never come from the money 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 from
On a complaint by a Sikh group, a US federal court has issued summons against Congress Party President Sonia Gandhi for shielding party officials allegedly involved in inciting attacks on Sikhs in November 1984, an attorney said. In a class action suit filed on Tuesday before the District Court of Eastern District of New York, Sikhs for Justice, a US-based human rights group, and other victims of the November 1984 anti-Sikh violence have sought compensatory and punitive damages against Gandhi. According to SFJ attorney Gurpatwant S. Panun, under federal rules, it has 120 days to serve the summons and complaint on Gandhi, who is currently visiting the US for medical checkup. The suit under Alien Tort Claims Act and Torture Victim Protection Act accuses Gandhi of shielding and protecting Kamal Nath, Sajjan Kumar, Jagdish Titler and other Congress Party leaders from being prosecuted for their alleged role in the 1984 violence. The 27-page complaint against Gandhi alleges that between November 1 and 4, 1984, about 30,000 members of the Sikh community, quotes, were intentionally tortured, raped and murdered by groups that were incited, organized, controlled and armed, unquotes, by the ruling Congress Party. The Syria war resolution drafted by members of the powerful U.S. Senate Foreign Relations Committee permits up to 60 days of military action against the Bashar al-Assad regime and does not permit any boots on the ground, congressional ally aides said. The Senate Foreign Relations Committee has crafted a bipartisan authorization for the use of military force that we believe reflects the will and concerns of Democrats and Republicans alike, Senator Robert Menendez, chairman of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, said after successfully negotiating with ranking member Bob Corker on the resolution authorization for the use of military force in Syria. However, the text of the draft resolution was not officially released. The resolution is likely to be put to vote before the committee today. The resolution, among other things, permitted the deployment of a small rescue mission in the event of an emergency, congressional aides said. Menendez said the resolution gives U.S. President Barack Obama the authority he needs to deploy force in response to the Assad regime's criminal use of chemical weapons against the Syrian people. The resolution also assures that the authorization is narrow and focused, limited in time, and assures that the armed forces of the U.S. will not be deployed for combat operations in Syria. Yesterday, Menendez presided over the Senate committee hearing on Syria. The Senate is expected to schedule a vote on the resolution early next week. Quotes, I do think we were able to address many of the issues that were raised today during the hearing. And I thought the hearing was fine. There wasn't any new ground broke, and I was glad that Secretary of State John Kerry reasserted the no boots on the ground point. And I'm sure that will also be addressed in writing, unquote, said Corker after the congressional hearing. A 5-year-old Chinese boy has become a Guinness World Record holder for becoming the youngest person to pilot a plane. He Yidi, nicknamed Duo Duo from Nanjing, made a 35-minute solo flight on ultralight aircraft across the Beijing Wildlife Park on August 31, the China Daily reports. According to the report, the boy received less than a month's training at a private pilot tourist farm in Langfang in China's Hebei province. A coach who sat next to him in the aircraft said he only helped a little, the report added. Yide had earlier hit the headlines in February 2012 when his video of running in the snow in his underwear went viral online. In August 2012, he sailed on a yacht twice his weight during the Qingdao International OP Regatta. In September 2012, the boy climbed Mount Fujiyama in Japan in 15 hours in the rain. The 5-year-old boy, who is done with all the lessons for primary students from grade 1 to 3 by this July, is set to attend classes with 4th grade students at Experiment at Primary School of Nanjing University of Science and Technology. And now let's take a look at the headlines once again. State cabinet resolves to punish those who sell or keep PDS items illegally. And Amoco reaffirms to stand for territorial integrity of Manipur. Thanks for watching ISTV News. Do stay tuned for more updates.